Hey, all you cuties out there. Today we're counting down the cutest baby animals. Not even the coldest of hearts can last through this cute, fuzzy video. Baby otters. Seriously, what's cuter than a baby freaking otter? Baby otters are born blind, so they're pretty helpless upon coming out of the womb. When an otter is premature, it's called a pup, and before it can start paving its own path into the world, baby otters are cared for by their mother and father. In fact, the otter family is often very tight-knit and protective. Before the babies are born, otter parents will stockpile their den with food to make sure that their new pup has plenty to eat. Newborn otters drink their mother's milk for about 40 days before they're ready to eat small plants and fish. Even though otters basically live in the water in adulthood, they can spend up to 6 hours straight in the water before taking a break. Baby otters are actually pretty afraid of swimming when they're little. Once they've taken some lessons from their parents, though, they can't seem to get enough of it. Baby lemurs. Like otters, baby lemurs are also called pups, considering the size of those puppy dog eyes. That name makes total sense. Upon birth, they weigh about 100 grams, which is equal to the weight of one cup of water. Lemurs are almost exclusively found on the islands of Madagascar and Comoro and are raised in troops, which usually consist of up to 27 lemurs. Talk about tribal living! The females of the troop are the leaders. They will care for the pups and gather food. Male lemurs, on the other hand, are free agents and go from troop to troop at will. Lemurs typically only give birth to one pup at a time, but it's actually very common for a female lemur to have twins. Baby lemurs attach themselves to the abdomens of their mothers for the first 2 weeks of life. They're especially good at holding on to their mothers tightly. After about 2 years, a baby lemur is ready to leave their mother's care and join another troop, or if they're female, stay and support their current one. Puppies. Okay, I know, Earth to Captain Obvious, puppies are cute, but we know we'd get a ton of comments asking why there wasn't puppies on this list, so here you go. The poster child of baby animals, puppies. It's probably no surprise to hear that newborn puppies spend the majority of their time sleeping and only wake up to drink their mother's milk. Puppies grow slowly when compared to other baby animals, and their teeth often don't start growing until they're about 6 months old. If you've ever had a puppy, this is the phase where they literally chew everything. Puppies start to hear about 2 weeks into life. They're almost completely deaf before that. The first bark usually happens about 1 month in, and as long as puppies have positive exposure to humans early on in their development, they'll most likely be very friendly and social. Puppies don't like their environment to change very much. Once they're settled into a home with their owner, they usually want it to stay that way. This is why dogs and puppies are considered to be man's best friend. Baby fennec fox. The fennec fox is one of the tiniest fox species in the world. While most foxes are usually compared to house cats, fennec foxes can be compared to kittens. In fact, when they're fully grown, fennec foxes stand only 8 inches tall. That's tiny! Baby fennec foxes, also called pups, will stay with their birth parents for as long as they care to. Unlike most other animals, fennec foxes mate for life, and each couple will have about 1 litter per year, and the kids will often stick around even after a new litter is born, because, well, they're family. Fennec foxes grow up quickly, maturing at about 9 months old, and can live up to 10 years in the wild, and 14 years in captivity. The fennec fox is basically made for the desert. They have padded paws which protect them from the hot sand, as well as a thick coat of white fur to shield them from both extreme hot and cold temperatures, which the desert is notorious for. The fennec fox also doesn't really need to drink water and can survive on the liquid they consume from prey, desert plants, and condensation. Baby pandas. Baby pandas are adorable, and they always look like they're smiling, don't they? It's a shame that this majestic animal is facing extinction, but luckily there are foundations that are saving these beautiful animals as we speak. Like most mammals, baby pandas come into this world fully developed, spending up to 160 days in its mother's womb. Despite spending a long time in the womb, baby pandas are born relatively small. Most newborn cubs are about the size of a stick of butter, and are considered to be the smallest newborns in the world in relation to their mother. Baby pandas can't even walk until 3 months. And even then, it's only a few wobbles. Not only are these little guys born tiny, they're born blind as well, so it's important that the mother takes extra special care of these delicate babies. They spend about 1 year feeding on their mother's milk before embarking on their first taste of bamboo. That's considered a very long feeding period compared to other species. They need a lot of attention, but hopefully, through their mother's care, they'll carry on the panda name. Baby red pandas. Red pandas are actually more closely related to raccoons than bears, yet they're still considered to be pandas. Strange, baby red pandas or cubs won't grow to nearly the size of a regular panda. They'll grow to about the size of a house cat after about 1 year. But similar to regular pandas, red baby pandas heavily rely on their mother in the first few months of birth, as they are born completely blind and deaf. Can you imagine that? You'd really have to trust your mama. Luckily, red panda mothers are good at prepping for birth and will often build a nest of leaves and sticks before her litter of 3 to 4 cubs are born to keep them safe and warm. The mother panda will even use her long bushy tail as a blanket for her young when the weather gets cold. How adorable is that? Piglets. Aren't baby pigs just the cutest ever? It kind of makes you never want to eat bacon ever again. A piglet is born after about 115 days in the womb and will often share that warm, cushy apartment with up to 12 other piglets. A mother pig will give birth about 2 times per year. That's a lot of piglets to take care of. Factor in the curious and playful nature of a piglet, and she's got her work cut out for her. Baby pigs are born being able to see and walk right away, which is uncommon compared to most other baby animals. Piglets grow up very fast and can start having their own piglets at about 6 months of age. It's been a popular trend in the past decade or so to adopt a baby pig as a household pet. Though this is legal in some areas of the world, it's always wise to check what your local legislation has to say about it before bringing a piggy home from the farm. Piglets are very social, so if you're going to get one as a pet, you should probably get 2 so they don't get lonely. Aww. Baby koalas. Good day, mate. Koalas are Australia's most cuddly and cute creature, but the babies are just next level. You might be surprised to hear this, but koalas are actually more closely related to kangaroos than bears. Why they're called bears? We don't know. Let's just say they're a cross between the two. A baby koala lives very close to its mother for the first year of its life. Attached like glue to her back, baby koalas, or joeys, live off of their mother's milk as well as eucalyptus, which is found high up in the treetops. Joeys have strong, sharp teeth from birth, which helps them rip through the eucalyptus leaves. Though eucalyptus is poisonous to most other animals, koalas, for some reason, are able to handle it. Like sloths, baby koalas are considered to be lazy animals and can spend up to 20 hours per day sleeping on their mother's back. Talk about the good life! Baby kangaroos. Like koalas, baby kangaroos are also called joeys and cling onto their mother tucked safely in her pouch for about a year until they're ready to jump on their own. The joey has access to mammary glands in the pouch itself, so the mother can go about her business without stopping to feed. A mother kangaroo can technically give birth to up to 4 babies at a time, but it's usually just one. The gestation period lasts between 21 to 38 days, which is crazy short, after which the baby, which is often as small as a bumblebee, gets guided into the pouch for 150 to 400 days to finish growing. Female joeys reach full maturity at 20 months, whereas males can take up to 4 years. Sounds about right. Baby alligators. Alligators hail from many areas around the world, including China and America, though they famously take up residence in the marshes of the southern states like Louisiana, Mississippi, and South Carolina. Alligators are known to be less aggressive than crocodiles, but if you cross them, they will give you a nip with their sharp teeth, which have been there since birth. Baby gators are protected for about a year by their parents before they go out on their own. They're born very weak with a poor metabolism, and due to their inability to move their tongue, they can't eat very much. So they must stay close to home until they've reached full adulthood, which could take up to 2 years. When baby alligators get scared, they use a special call to tell their parents that they're in trouble. Simply adorable. Baby hedgehog. Just like alligators are the less aggressive counterpart of the crocodile, hedgehogs are the gentler version of porcupines. Their quills are a lot shorter and softer than porcupines, and lay flat, which is why a lot of people have adopted hedgehogs as pets. Baby hedgehogs, or hoglets, are born in litters of 4 or 5. However, not all of the hoglets will survive due to the hedgehog's tendency to eat its young. If the mother is disturbed in some way, she will desert or eat her young. Don't ask why, it's just hedgehog nature. Once the hoglets are 3 to 4 weeks old, they'll go off on a foraging trip with their mother, and will often stay out of the nest from that point onward. Once the mother sees that they know what they're doing, they're on their own. Hedgehogs are never usually expected to live longer than a year due to their sensitivity to the cold weather. Unless they put on enough weight to last hibernation, they typically won't survive the winter. It's tough out there for a baby hedgehog. Baby elephants. Baby elephants are probably the biggest baby animals in the world, and also, in our opinion, one of the cutest. Baby elephants spend about 2 years in their mother's wombs. Can you imagine that? That's crazy. More than double the time a human spends in there. Due to the long gestation period, baby elephants can often walk the second they're born. Though sometimes twins are born, a mother elephant will rarely ever give birth to more than one calf at a time. So the baby will have to wait another 2 years before they get a brother or sister. A baby elephant will drink the equivalent of 40 glasses of milk per day. When you're born 2 feet tall, you need all the nourishment you can get. This is kind of cute, but it takes a while for a baby elephant to learn to use its trunk. So the mom elephant will usually feed it leaves until it learns how to control it, which usually happens after about 1 year of life. When a baby is born into a herd, the adult elephants will often come to surround the elephant to welcome it into the world. Basically crying over here, too cute to handle. I hope you can still breathe from all the cuteness we've thrown your way. I'm seriously considering adopting a pig.